Instagram might finally be doing what users have been asking for years, bringing back the chronological feed. But will it actually be a good thing for small creators? Let's talk about it. Hey, what's up? I'm Katie, and here on YouTube, I love to share all my best advice about social media marketing and creative entrepreneurship. Last night, I was scrolling through Twitter, which, of course, is the best thing to do when you're trying to fall asleep. And I came across this tweet by Jane Wong. Instagram is working on a latest posts feed for catching up on feed posts. This sounds like the chronological feed people are asking for. Similar, but not the same, side eye. For those of you who are shook, I want to give you a little bit of background of how we get this information. I've been following Jane on Twitter for a while, and she is this super cool genius code hackery type person. Honestly, I don't understand exactly how she finds out the stuff that she does, but what I do know is that she searches through code and is somehow able to compare the current release of the app and its code with like code that they're working on. Like, I don't understand it. That's why she does it and not me. But she very generously shares her findings on her Twitter account, which is at WongMJane, which you should totally follow. And she does this for all kinds of different social media platforms, whether it's like Tinder, Instagram, Facebook, like whatever it is, she can find out what these apps are currently working on and what's in development, and then she kind of gives her followers sneak peeks at what might be coming down the line for these apps. So this is not just theories, this is not just like ideas of like, oh, Instagram could do this. This is stuff that she's actually discovering in the code when she goes searching through it in her magical genius way. Like I said, I have no idea how. So today what I want to talk about is not whether or not Instagram is doing this, because based on what Jane is posting, it does look like they're developing this latest post's new feature. But what I want to talk about instead is that actually going to be helpful for you as a creator? And what does chronological versus algorithm all mean, and how do we deal with that? So just to clarify, this does not look like it's a universal change to the entire feed. This is just going to be one feature within Instagram. But what I find so interesting is that so many people are reacting like, this is exactly what we've been asking for. We just want this from Instagram so badly. Screw the algorithm. We need a chronological feed. And I think that that line of thought is a little bit misguided. What got me most about this tweet is the number of people who are replying like, yes, this is exactly what we've been waiting for. Instagram is finally listening to us. And honestly, I am shook by that, because I'm kind of like, guys, we've had the algorithm for like 4 years now, and you're still waiting for the chronological feed to come back? Here's the truth. Let's think logically about this. Instagram is not going to invest years and millions of dollars into developing the highly complex algorithm that they now use to keep users on their platform and serve ads to them. They're not going to throw that all away in exchange for a chronological feed again, which is like the most old school proto social media thing. It just doesn't make sense for them as a company. Sure, maybe it makes sense to add a feature like latest posts that will keep users engaged for a little bit longer. Maybe they've done some research that shows if people log on to Instagram and see posts that have been published within the last hour that they're more likely to stay on the app longer. Who knows what their reasoning is? So since I recorded this video, there's actually been a development with this. I follow Jane on Instagram, and she posted this saying that, as it turns out, the latest posts feature that she was talking about on Twitter is actually just the result of an internal Instagram hackathon. So this feature is not going to be released anytime soon, and you don't have to worry about that changing your Instagram experience. However, I still wanted to release this video and show it to you guys, because everything I said about chronological feed versus algorithm feed is exactly the same. I think it's still valid, and I think it's still important for you all to know why a chronological feed would not be necessarily better for you than an algorithm feed, and why I think it's important to appreciate and understand the algorithm. But if you just think about it from a business standpoint, there's no way they're going to completely forego their algorithm for a chronological feed, because it just doesn't make sense for them as a business.
Especially because it's apparently not actually real.
And here's my argument to you. I don't think it makes sense for you as a creator either. I think that the algorithm is actually going to be more helpful to you than a chronological feed, and here's why. If Instagram went ahead and did what everybody seems to be begging for and switched from an algorithm-based feed to a chronological feed overnight, you would probably not only lose followers, but also start hating Instagram, like, almost instantly. As a user, it would just be a completely unpleasant experience, and here's why. Having a chronological feed incentivizes creators to spam their followers constantly. People only see things in real time, which means that the people you follow are going to be posting constantly in order to make sure that the most number of people following them see their content. That means that your feed is going to be all of a sudden full with posts from the same account, and it's just going to be not something you're interested in and not great content. If you remember back to the days of the chronological feed of like 2016 and before, sometimes you would see the same person post like 5 times in a row and it would be like, I'm not interested in this. But with the current algorithm-based feed, you would never see that content because chances are only one of those 5 posts would actually get the engagement rate necessary for it to be delivered to your feed. Another reason you would stop looking Instagram with a chronological feed is because chances are the majority of the posts you would see in your feed, you would not know who the creators are. Think about it. You might be following hundreds of people. I follow about 300, which is actually on the low end of Instagram. And there's no way I see posts from all of those 300 people. If I all of a sudden started seeing those posts, I would like quit the app because I'd be like, who is this? I don't know who it is. I'm not interested in it anymore. The Instagram algorithm works really hard to learn what you are interested in, what you do want to see, and then they keep showing it to you. So as a user, it is just a much better experience to be served content that, first of all, you know is engaging, you know it's sort of risen to the top, and you know it's from creators that you recognize and enjoy, because Instagram isn't going to show you content that you don't want to engage with. Or at least that is not the goal. Of course, the algorithm is not perfect. Maybe sometimes you'll see stuff that's boring. Maybe there's some stuff you wish you saw, like hopefully my posts. Turn on post notifications. But it's trying its best to serve content that is going to be engaging to you. So that's why as a user of Instagram, having a chronological feed would just not be nearly as good of an experience as an algorithm-based feed. But here's why as a creator, it was not fun to create for a chronological feed, even though people seem to idealize that point in time and think, oh, back then, all of my followers saw my posts. I got so much better engagement. People actually saw what I was doing. I didn't have to fight with the algorithm. Well, guess what? The algorithm is trying to help you. And if you just learn what it wants, then you can make sure that your content gets shown to the most people possible. Back when it was a chronological feed, like I mentioned before, you were sort of incentivized to post as often as possible because you wanted to reach the highest number of people possible. So you had to post every day or multiple times a day just for your content to be seen. Now on Instagram, a post has a shelf life of anywhere from 24 to 48 hours, which is quite long in the world of social media. So you can put more time and effort into making each piece of content super high quality and super high value for your audience because you know they'll have a longer chance of seeing it. If a feed is chronological, then you're forced to be online at the ideal times to reach your followers. It's a lot more time sensitive. It is going to completely change the schedule of your day, week, your life, just to try to reach the people you want to reach on Instagram. And yes, with the algorithm feed, you do definitely want to keep in mind the best time to post. However, you know that your posts are going to reach more people even after they are posted because it's going to keep being recommended by Instagram up to 48 hours after you post it, maybe even longer. The algorithm also provides way more discoverability for new creators because if you understand what the algorithm is looking for, then you can create content that is going to do well and maybe even be recommended on the explore page. And when I say explore page, of course I really mean explore pages because everyone's is different. There's not just one universal explore page that we all see. Instagram curates it based on your interests, what you engage with, and what they think you want to see. If it weren't for the algorithm, none of what happens on the explore page would be possible, and so people wouldn't be able to find your content as easily if they didn't already know who you were. So this new latest post feature is definitely going to be an interesting addition to Instagram's functionality, and I'm excited to check it out and see how it works once it gets released. But at the end of the day, it is not going to impact the overall feed structure. It's still going to be an algorithm.
Especially because apparently it's not actually a real feature.
It just makes way more sense for it to be an algorithm, and I want you to stop wishing that it wasn't, because honestly, it's better for you if it is an algorithm, especially if you pay attention and learn the tricks of the trade to make the algorithm work for you. If you want to know all of my theories and strategies about the 2020 Instagram algorithm and how you can use it to your advantage, then go check out this video because I think it's going to be very useful for you when it comes to crafting your content. So make sure you go click on over to that video because you're not going to want to miss it. And as always, thanks so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you over in that one. Okay, bye.